Shalom, shalom, shalom. I'm your host, Big Truck, here at the King's Table. And you know what I do. We have men discussions. It's going to be a short video, but you know how I like to do. I like to give it to you raw and uncut, with a little bit of truth, getting down to the root of it all. In this video here, you know, we're going to see how a single-ass mother, her standards, a man has to make 500K. This is some delusional shit at its best. So as men, we're going to do what we do best. Let's spit fire.
I find it really stupid when I see men trying to make it a point that single mother standards are way too high. But wouldn't you think that a good mother or a good woman, period, would want the best for her children and want the best around her children? So you best believe that my standards are going to be through the roof. At this point, my standards are so high, I think I'm looking for Jesus Christ himself.
You're going to keep looking for his ass because you ain't going to find him. Standards like that. Delusion. I got to take a sip on that one. Here's the thing. Let me give it to you like this. Okay. Modern society. You can't ask for a traditional man and you're not a traditional woman. You a modern woman. Shit ain't gonna work. If you asking for a traditional man, you need to be a traditional woman. Those your standards, which is fine. Let's see how that work for you. It's okay for you. Let a man have standards. Okay, my standards. Woman got to be with me. She can't have no fake ass eyelashes and no long fingernails. You know, the talons, the claws. Oh, can't have none of that. Got to be a feminine woman. Got to be fit. Got to be friendly. Friendly, fit, and feminine. Submissive. Treat me like a king, I treat you like a queen. 50-50. That's my standards. Is my standards high? No. I can care less about how much money you make. Long as we both are able to multiply our incomes. Times has changed. Two incomes is better than one. This whole fantasy of a man got to make this much, man got to take care of me, man got to do this. There's a reason why your ass is still single and ain't got nobody. Let's continue.
Absolutely, Kendra. My standards are very, very high when it comes to that. He needs to be making at least half a mil.
Oh, shit. A half a mil. If he's making a half a mil, why the hell will he want you? Look how you look. Big ass nostrils. Weave. Sandaling up. Even Kendra, you don't know what to say. That's just some unrealistic shit. The stuff that come out of these, a large number of these women's mouth is pathetic. Really pathetic. Should be ashamed of yourself. Let's get some more of this. I know, yep. Kendra. I know.
This guy commented and said that my dating standards are too high for someone that's a single mother.
Right.
I have high standards because I'm a single mother. I cannot afford to let somebody play in my face. And who told you that being a single mother disqualifies you from actually having standards and having to settle? I don't know who misled you, but the moment that I became a single mother was the moment I knew I cannot settle.
What if I told you the more status and money I'm...
We're going to stop right there. Shout out to these, you know, gentlemen on Fit and, Fresh and Fit. I like to go on their show one day. But don't want to digress from the point that I'm making here. Here's the thing. When we talk about these high standards, you have to be realistic. And ladies, I don't know what the hell are y'all drinking. What's in the damn Kool-Aid? That's what I want to know. What is in the damn Kool-Aid that got your mind so delusional? Having these high standards for these men, but these men don't want you. You notice that, right? If a man of those high standards that you require, why would they want you? What do you offer them besides a piece of ass? Like I tell both men and women, I don't care how good your coochie is, how big your penis is, both of those don't pay bills. You gotta offer something more than just that. But here's the thing, I gotta drive this home to the men, kings. You gotta know who you are and whose you are. You have to set your limitations and set your standards, but be realistic with it. Let's get this here.
A man has, the more likely he's gonna want a girl that's younger, more beautiful, etc., and doesn't have kids.
Okay, go ahead. You got that, and just like how I got married before, I could do it again.
You got married before, but you would do it again. Why did your ass get divorced the first time? What happened the first marriage? Don't worry.
So many other people in this world that there's another man out there. You see
how the rest of the chickens clapping and congratulating? Yes, there's another man, but why would he want you? If you haven't learned the first time, you're gonna make the same damn mistake again. Like she said, I get married once, I get married again. Marriage ain't no game. It takes work. It takes work. But I believe 80% of the divorce has been filed by women. And there is a higher percentage of men that they try to fight for their marriage and want to work it out and do what they can to work it out, but it just don't work. You can't treat marriage like you do a relationship. A relationship, if relationship is not working out, you out. You just up and you go. You can't do a marriage like that. Somebody should have told my ex-wife that same shit right there. Let's get it, let's wrap it, let's bring it home.
Hey, so you want a millionaire. Okay, you want a millionaire.
Standards being high sounds great. I'm with it. But single mothers need to get out their own head and realize that the average man who's making about $500,000 a year, who's 6 feet tall and faithful, 9 times out of 10 will not be choosing you.
Boom! Now
we will dive deep on those feet.
There it is right there. He will not be wanting you when he has other options. So I'm gonna leave it at this. You can check the rest of the video. I'm gonna leave a description in the box. Remember, I'm a new channel. I'm here to grow. It's the King's Table. I'm here to bring light, truth to darkness, and just bring the truth to the men. A platform for men that can come and be themselves and express, and you know, and everything be Irie, you know? Until then, shalom.